We're on the edge of the Mississippi, western Wisconsin. It's called Coulee Country, and it's a French word for valley. I feel very comfortable here.
The opportunity of working, of course, with Herman Miller was like a dream come true in a way. It's like playing baseball for the Yankees. But don't take me wrong, I hate the Yankees.
New York definitely affects the way I design because there's an energy here. There's an energy around the way people live, but I think there's also a creative buzz here.
Berlin is very inspiring because it's changing so much. There are two different cultures merging in this city.
7.5 is a collaborative design team. Four partners, three designers, one engineer.
It's more like a music band, so everybody contributes and we don't want to be separated into different individuals.
Sometimes, as a designer, you feel like being partially anthropologist because you always observe people in order to try to find out what they really need.
The human body has some very narrow margins when it comes to being comfortable. If your shoe is uncomfortable, you're aware of it. So how do you get people to a point of comfort? Is you make them unaware. And that's not easy to do.
One idea that I became familiar with from Herman Miller was the notion of inevitability. And the way I would interpret that is a product or a solution that has a kind of truth to it.
You want construction to tell you the truth about the nature of the object you're dealing with.
Always believed in physical design, which means you go from iteration to iteration physically, not just on the computer or not just with drawings.
At first, I'm sort of reaching all over the place when I start working on something, and I have a general idea, but I just don't know specifically what I'm looking for. It's almost like searching for a light switch in a darkened room.
This was designed around the idea of, say, I want to sit on this really bad, and we got that reaction. And then people did sit on it, and we got a lot of wow. And when those two things come together, you know you've got something.
My idea is to design pieces that can somehow fit effortlessly into your life.
Design is not like just having a beautiful item. Design has to be used.
I always think of a quality where you could almost walk right past something that I designed and not really think much about it. But as you use it, there's a lot of nuances that I try to put into my product, which you come to appreciate and know.
The best design is design that where you learn something about an object or a category of objects that you did not know before. Copies are so disappointing because they are boring in a way. I mean, there's a moral side to it and there's an aesthetic side to it. The aesthetic side is they're boring. The moral side is they're deceiving.
You can go in some corporations and see all the pieces of a competitive chair on pegboard with labels on the parts, and they're copied directly. What I worry about is what we're working on and what I've not seen before, and that's where I put my energy.
When somebody takes something of themselves and puts it into the work that they're doing, it's almost like writing a letter to somebody with a piece of yourself inside.
The only guarantee we have that we can come up with an original idea is our own curiosity, our own nosiness.
The people who set the reference points,
there's something in them, in their spirit, that drives them towards that originality, drives them towards that place.
Designers, I'm convinced, are idealistic people. They have this certain feeling in the stomach when they see things which are not as good as they should be. And this is actually the driver for the curiosity then to move forward and try to come up with a better solution than what is standard at the time.
I enjoy myself, and I do it through design.